Okay, now we are going to intensify the color of the actual petals. So I've made up another mixture of my gamboge and lemon yellow. And we're just going to, in the areas that we see that are darker, we're going to maintain the yellow on some of these, but some of these petals that are darker, we're going to go back in there and drop a little darker color in there. So I think we'll do that on this one. Particularly if the petal is in shadow, you're going to see a darker color there. And not necessarily have to put it everywhere. And if you want, because we're going to drop that gold burnt sienna in a minute. The tips are, everything is darker down here. Even though the sun was pretty much coming from this direction, so these will be more in shadow down here. So we'll go ahead and do that. Paint around that. And these will be deeper. And they really, honestly, we could add a tiny bit of burnt sienna to this, and I think I will. Let's see what we get. Especially for those that are behind the others. So you can always tweak your colors. Well, that's just one, maybe. One petal there. Yep, and there's one happening here. And if you want a softer effect, you can just wet the petal first. And then drop in streaks of the color, which will also work. Which is kind of a nice look. We need to just work our way around here. And let's put this one in shadow back here. These are getting brighter up here. This one is not very bright though. So we'll go with that. That one's behind. Sure, what's going on here? We need to soften that. Really don't want any hard edges here on these petals. So if you get a hard edge, just go back in and soften it. Push that back. Give this one some streaks in there. So now I'm just using the straight gamboge to bring some different color in here. And then if you do it that way, you can just come in here and soften the edges here so that you don't get the hard lines. Okay, and I think that was part of this one as well. So we'll kind of put that in like that. Okay, let's go for some of the straight gamboge up here. And if you want to come off like this and just leave the streaks, because there are lots and lots of streaks in these petals. And just to vary it up a little bit, we'll put a little bit of burnt sienna in there, push that one to the back. And go back in with our straight gamboge up here. Now this one is really lemony. This one is almost totally brown. So we'll go ahead and drop that in, and then we'll come back in with the burnt sienna there. Let's put some of these darker in the back. The ones that are in the background. That's what gives us dimension and realism. Okay. Now we're going to start dropping in the burnt sienna. Not on the entire thing though. So we just want to soften the edges there. And that's a bit bright, that burnt sienna. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the burnt sienna, the bright burnt sienna, and we're going to add a little bit of our brown mixture to it. And remember, that was just Payne's Gray and burnt sienna. That's going to give us a nicer, more realistic color. Okay. And we do want some of these to come all the way down, but most of them actually start at the base, if you notice, and come up like this. So they're almost like it's solid at the base of the petal, and then it comes out like this. So it's really a bit softer there. I think that's, don't know, okay, that's a different petal back there. So let's make that a little more gamboge. Well, not when you've got burnt sienna on your brush. Okay, let's take that up. Let's drop that. Right. And then this one actually comes like this and stops right there. So we'll just wet this and let it blend in. And I'm going to make this petal back here just slightly different. So you can see that that's a different petal back there. And then we've got just a few. Again, it's all solid here. And then it just comes out this way. Here. And remember, we still have our masking fluid on here as well. So, just do some loose. Actually, I think it's probably easier just to come in this way. And then fill that in. Maybe not. Maybe we'll come out that way. Whatever works for you. I got too much water there we need to pick up. We want to soften this edge. We'll go back in when it's dry and add some more definition. Right now we're just mapping out where everything is, pretty much. That is. That's part of that. Okay, I'm liking that. I've pulled some of the brown down. That's kind of nice. And remember, we don't to overdo, which is really easy to do. There. So, just a different variation of sometimes wetting it and dropping the colors in, and sometimes dropping the color in and then softening it. Just always keeping it darker at the base of the petals, because that's how it really is. I might be pulling that burnt sienna too far down, which is what I did the last time in my sketchbook. So let's lift some of that back up. Let's actually, let's do that. Pull some of that back up out of there. I don't like that that's down there like that on the hole. I want some of that petal soft like that. So see, it's easy to pick up this stuff if you get it too far down, just like that. It's probably not a bad idea just to model it anyway so you don't get it so heavy. Because it's really easy to do. I think I'll lighten that a little bit. And take some of that off the tips. Like that. I like that better. Okay, let's soften this. With clean water, though, so we don't want any hard edges. Suck that up. Okay, now let's come in like this and just bring that out like that and then blend it into here like that. And that should give us that softness we want. Okay. I'm mixing up a little more burnt sienna with a little brown. You can see this hole radiates out the whole way. You really have to keep that intensity there, or it's not going to look right. We'll just go ahead and put it in. That's using the belly of the brush. And some of this comes down further. And some bring all the way down, some come all the way down, some don't. And some come all the way out, and some don't. This is kind of a dry brush technique here. There's very little water on my brush, and if I wanted to do it this way and get that, soften that, I could do it this way. I'm liking this. So I think really, in order to get that same look, I'm gonna turn this way. Mix up some more burnt sienna. I'm just gonna bring it down into here with a light, just the lightest brush stroke. Trying to keep that balanced. Because it's fairly symmetrical, it does go out in a few places like that. That's probably the best brush stroke like that. Just barely touch, I am barely touching this, board. That's how you get those really light strokes. We're losing a definition of our petals a little bit, but that's okay. That's more dry brush. Oh, we'll be back shortly.